advantage. We're going to show you how to use a little secret advertisers have been using on you for decades. And it might just help you get your next job.
Stacy, have a seat.
So far, we've seen what happens when your brain is on the receiving end of persuasion. Wouldn't it be great if you could take control and do the persuading yourself? For instance, wouldn't you like to know how to be more persuasive, let's say, getting a date or applying for a job? Well, we're about to recreate an experiment described by Nobel Prize-winning economist Daniel Kahneman in his fascinating book, Thinking Fast and Slow. We've asked a few volunteers to play boss for the day and interview two candidates for the same job. Play along with our boss and decide which candidate you would hire. Listen carefully. The interviews will go by quickly. Here comes candidate number one.
Hi.
Hello, I'm Stephanie.
Stephanie, Rico. Pleasure to meet you. Have a seat. Great. So how'd you hear about the company?
From my school.
Okay. So tell me a little bit about yourself.
I'm serious, hardworking, and creative. I'm also moody, nitpicky, and brutally honest.
Okay, that's candidate number one. What do you think? Okay, now get ready for candidate number two.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Stacy.
So, here's the key to the experiment. We're using identical twins with identical resumes, which eliminates all the variables except candidates' own words. Listen closely to candidate number two. You're going to have to decide soon which one to hire.
Tell me a little bit about yourself.
I'm brutally honest, nitpicky, and moody. But I'm also creative, hardworking, and serious.
Got it. Let's listen to the most important information one more time. You can make your decision.
I would have chosen number one.
I'm serious, hardworking, and creative. I'm also moody, nitpicky, and brutally honest. I'm brutally honest, nitpicky, and moody. But I'm also creative, hardworking, and serious.
So which one would you hire?
Number one.
One or two?
Number one.
Let's see who the interviewer picks.
I would be more prone to go with the first candidate. The first one, my mind, it opened up. Second one, had more like a negative vibe.
So, was number one your choice?
Yep.
In fact, 80% of the people we ran this experiment on hired applicant number one.
I think I would go with Stephanie, which would be the first girl that I saw.
The first candidate.
The first candidate.
I think so.
She seems to have a more positive outlook.
And there's a reason why.
Because of how she's
in this case, the first information you hear stands out, and your brain uses that to color all later information. This is known as the primacy effect.
You probably noticed the girls are using the exact same words. Only the order is different.
Serious, hardworking, creative, moody, nitpicky, brutally honest. Brutally honest, nitpicky, moody, creative, hardworking, serious.
And that order makes all the difference. Everybody knows you want to start with your best foot forward. But what's amazing is why. In situations like these, your brain actually starts to shut down after the first word or two. In an effort to take a shortcut, it quickly decides yes or no and doesn't pay much attention to the information. In test after test, the vast majority of people chose the applicants who started with positive words.
It's amazing that if you just change the order of adjectives, it can completely change the impression the person makes on you.
From primacy to the expert fallacy to priming, salesmen, advertisers, and politicians have been refining their techniques of persuasion for decades.
Now that you've learned how some of the techniques of persuasion work, you might be better at spotting the methods. For example, try to finish my sentence. I'm thirsty. I'd like a nice cold glass of
water.
So, what beverage comes most quickly to mind? Juice, milk, or water?
Water.
If milk was your answer, there's a reason.
It might be because we get milk throughout the episode.
If you were thinking milk.
Milk!
I never even saw those.
It may be because we put the thought for you. persuasion.
So is this your choice?
No.
Or is it just an illusion?
How?
If you were wondering if people took Jay Painter's news story seriously, without the suit, camera, and microphone, check this out.
Let me ask you a question. Today, Texas announced that they are breaking away from the United States, seceding from the United States. I just wanted to hear what your feelings were about that. Yeah, really? It's been all over the news. You haven't heard it?
You let it
be? No, it's all over the news. Have you heard this?
I haven't heard about that.
Yeah, look at the news.
Really?
Yes.
I watch the news every night, man. I haven't heard that.
I really don't have time for this.
Well, who are you anyway?
That's
the joke. That's what happened, man. I'm sorry, man.
Go back to the car. Why do you like Coco?
It's
a good movie. Good movie. Yeah, good, good.
You got the remote. You got the remote figured out.
Figured out.
Yeah, figured out.
Yeah, figure game.
Seems today, all you see is violence in movies and sex.
I already matter.
But where are those good old fashioned values in which we used to allow?
Life.
Lucky there's a Family Guy.
Oh!
Lucky there's a man who positively can do.
The big cry.
Laugh and cry.